All right, Joey. I'm here. Let's see if we can find what you wanted me to see.
This lift could use a few dry cells. Let's see what you're hiding down there, old friend. Another day, another dollar. How do I get this to work? Who put this here? Oh my God. Joey, what were you doing?
punching in.
Hey, here's my old desk. I wasted so much time in this chair.
Looks like they knocked out a wall or two after I left. Guess it took a few people to replace me.
Okay, that's all of them. Now I just need to get the ink flowing somehow. Should be a switch around here somewhere. Then I can start up the main power. Thank you.
This will definitely come in handy. There's only one thing to do. Press on. See if I can find a way out. How did this place get so big?
I said, can I get an amen?
Hello? Excuse me, can you help me? Hello?
Rest your head. It's time.
Where the hell did he go? Need to get power to this gate somehow. Should be a couple switches nearby. Then maybe I can open it. Out of here. I'll need to find a way to drain it.
Every day, the same strange thing happens. I'll be up here in my booth, the band will be swinging, and suddenly Sammy Lawrence just comes marching in and shuts the whole thing down. Tells us all to wait in the hall. Then I use him. He starts up my projector and he dashes for the projection booth and down the recording studio like the little devil himself was hidden behind. A few seconds later, the projector turns on. But Sammy, oh no, he don't come out for a long time. This man is weird. Crazy weird. I've got half a mind to talk to Mr. Jewel about all this. I really do. But then again,
installs this ink machine over our heads. Then it begins to leak. 3 times last month we couldn't even get out of our department because the ink had flooded the stairwell. Joey's solution. An ink pump to drain it periodically. Now I have this ugly pump switch right in my office. People in and out all day. Thanks, Joey. Just what I needed. More distractions. These stupid cartoon songs don't write themselves, you know?
Well, there's the pump switch, all right. That's one hell of a leak blocking the door, though. If I could just stop that ink from flowing, maybe I can get in. Always on time.
Show playfully plucks. The drum thunders in triumph. The banjo, once again, strums its melody. The bass fiddle sings with deep articulation. Sing my song, and my sanctuary will open to you.
I better get overtime for this. There's no valve. Where did it go? Sorry I had to do that. Nice hat, though.
I love the quiet. And that's hard to come by in these busy times. And yeah, sure, it may stink to high heaven down here, but it's just perfect for an old lyricist like me. Sammy's songs always got some bounce, but if I didn't get away once in a while, they'd never have any words to go with them. So I'll keep my mind to singing and my nose closed.
Okay, that should do it.
nice and tight.
We wouldn't want our sheep roaming away now, would we?
No, we wouldn't. I must admit, I am honored you came all the way down here to visit me. It almost makes what I'm about to do seem cruel. But the believers must honor their savior. I must have him notice me. Wait, you look familiar to me. That face. Not now, for our Lord is calling to us, my little sheep. The time of sacrifice is at hand. And then I will finally be freed from this prison, this inky, dark abyss I call a body. Shh. Quiet. Listen. I can hear him crawling above, crawling. Let us begin. The ritual must be completed. Soon he will hear me. He will set us free.
Someone there? I know you're in here. Come out and show yourself. I'm not getting out of here that easy. Need to open the door, but the lever is missing. Boris probably has it. Hey, buddy, you seen that lever handle around? Or are you holding it hostage until I make you something to eat? I thought so. Let's see what we got. That should be enough. Here you go. Let's see what's out there. Oh no. Looks like it's really dark up ahead. Let's find some light. Don't be scared, Boris. I'll keep the light near you so you don't get lost. Did you hear that? Yeah, me either. Another dead end. I don't see any other way through. You got any ideas, Boris? Wow, I don't remember any of this. Always on time. Why is there always something blocking the door? Gotta be a way through.
Some of those bendy dolls with a crooked smile. That's sure no reason for Mr. Drew to be flying Spiderweb. Come along now. Let's see if you're worthy to walk with angels.
Boris, oh, you scared me to death. Don't suppose you found anything we can use to protect ourselves with. This will do. Looks like to open this, we need to throw two levers at once. You get this one. I'll find the other.
You're so interesting. So different. I have to say, I'm an instant fan. Looks like you've got a date with an angel. Come to me now. Level 9. Just follow the screams. There's a whole twisted world out here.
These blasted elevators. Sometimes they open, sometimes they don't. Sometimes they come, sometimes they keep on going to hell and back. I keep telling these people, if Mr. Joey Drew keeps cutting corners like this, someone's sure to end up falling to their death. And it sure ain't gonna be me. I'm taking the stairs.
to make me so beautiful. Anything less than perfect is left behind. I had to do it. She made me.
Who would have thought? Me, having lunch with Joey Giroux. Apparently times are tougher than I thought. For a moment there, I thought I'd be stuck with the check. But I gotta say, he wasn't at all what I expected. Quite the charmer. He even called me Alice. I liked it. Now we come to the question. Do I kill you? Do I tear you apart to my heart's delight? The choices of the beautiful are unbearable. How's a girl to choose? Take this little freak, for instance. He crawled in here, trailing his tainted ink to my door. It could have touched me. It could have pulled me back. Do you know what it's like? Living in the dark puddles? It's a buzzing, screaming well of voices. Bits of your mind swimming like fish in a bowl. The first time I was born from its inky womb, I was a wiggling, pulsing, shapeless slug. The second time, well, it made me an angel. Ascend and leave this place. If you will do a few easy, weensy little favors for me first. Return to the lift, my little errand boy. We have work to do. My machines are hungry. Gather me some spare parts. There are so few rules to our world now. So little
truth.
But there is one rule we all know and respect down here. Beware the ink demon. Stay out in the open for too long and he will find you. For if you see him, you'd better hide. If you don't, well, I enjoy our meat. Now, let us begin our work. Have you met him? The ink demon. They say he hears everything. Every creak of the floor, every rustle of paper. I wouldn't run so fast if I were you. You never know what will draw him in.
One down. This one's empty. Nothing in here. Oh.
should be plenty. Return them to me. And try not to die on the way back. Gonna catch them, you'll have to learn to move quietly. Come back to my door. I have something that you'll need.
Back to the old grind.
Bring me back my equipment, please. Once upon a time, there was an angel, and she was beautiful and loved by all. She was perfect, no matter what Joey says.
Better get overtime for this.
I'll make this simple. Look for valve pads. Turn the little wheels. Then bring me their power cores. Please don't make me regret sparing you. I can always change my mind.
The old grind.
Efficient little errand boy, aren't you?
In.
You see those grinning demons? Let's remove them, shall we? I've got just the tool to make this even more enjoyable.
Always on time. Another day, another dollar. Another day, another dollar.
Thank you.
friends, don't you?
Oh, I hate leaving work unfinished.
Fortunately, I have you to pick up the pieces. But you'll have to go even deeper. Down, down, down into the abyss. Take the lift down. Say hello to an old friend. Sending you a little present. A little firepower. Take good care of it. It belonged to someone very special. It's a little hard to get a hold of. Oh well, better luck next time.
Back to the old grind. lounging in.
It seems we've reached the end of my to-do list, my little errand boy. I hope you enjoyed our time together. I'll always treasure it. Return to the lift. It's time to go home. Definitely something missing here.
They told me I was perfect for the role. Absolutely perfect. Now Joey's going around, saying things behind closed doors. I can always tell. Now he wants to meet again tomorrow, says he has an opportunity for me. I'll hear him out. But if that smooth talker thinks he can double-cross an angel and get away with it, well, oh, he's got another thing coming. Alice? Ooh, she doesn't like liars.
So that's how it works. I can get across here if I can find a way to fix this.
Peace. For 40 years, I've built attractions that stagger the imagination. Colossal wonders, such as the world has never seen. I have earned my legacy with sweat. Right in front of everyone. High-level investors, Wall Street tycoons. The ever-tactless Joey Drew introduces me, the great Bertram Piedmont, as Bertie, like I was his child. You may be paying me, Mr. Drew, but you don't own me. I'll build you a park bigger than anything you could ever possibly conceive. But before you go taking any bows, Mr. Drew, know that this grand achievement will belong to me, and to me alone.
This haunted house seems like the way to go, but it's gonna need some power. Hang in there, Boris. I'm coming.
Rescue party.
One.
Thank you.
Looks like I've got some company up ahead. Without some kind of weapon, I don't stand a chance. There's gotta be a way around them.
The only thing that works around here is my ulcer. Half these people don't know a wrench from a dang steamroller. Bunch of morons is what they are. Spend their day in the warehouse arguing over who's supposed to be doing what and playing them silly games. Still, I'm not complaining. I get most of my time to myself. Suits me just fine. Only thing that bothers me is that mechanical demon in the corner. Bertram's been working on it for a month now. Says it'll walk someday, maybe dance. All it does now is give me the creeps. I swear, when my back's turned, that thing's moving.
Park ever built. A centerfold of attractions. Each one more grand than the one before it. It makes my eyes come to tears at the thought. But then, oh, Mr. Drew, for all your talk of dreams, you are the true architect behind so many nightmares. I built this park. It was to be a masterpiece. My masterpiece. And now you think you can just throw me out? Trample me to the dust and forget me? No! This is my park. My glory. You may think I'm wrong. But I'm still here.
Thank you.
That makes three. One to go.
Thank you.
Now, the ride truly begins, Henry. Come in and pretend it's all just a bad dream. It's a funny thing, how so much can fall apart so fast. We never really had control of the studio. Either you were in someone's pocket, or you were putting someone into yours. I just wanted what was promised to me. I just wanted to be beautiful. Surely you can understand that. Henry, why are you here? We're all dying to find out. Do you just enjoy the terror of the drop into hell? Because if that's the case, hang on tight. I've got a surprise.
Boris! No, no, what has she done to you?
Meet the new and improved Boris! I took what I wanted, and in return, I gave him so much more! And this time, there's no ink deal. No.
Thank you.
I know that song.
Everyone knows that song. Who are you? Why are you here?
I was invited by an old friend. And now I can't leave.
Then you know more than we do. One minute, we don't even exist. Just thoughts. And the next minute, this place.
Are you gonna let me out of here?
Down here, strangers aren't good things. How can we trust you? We don't even know what you are.
My name is Henry. I used to work here.
I honestly don't know my name. So, they call me Alice. But I'm no angel. You go back and rest. We'll talk again later. It's only for a few hours. No need to worry. I won't go far. Only up to level 6. Just stay here. Keep an eye on Henry, okay? I'll be back as soon as I can. I promise. Henry? Here. You must be hungry. Sorry, it's all we have. I know you're watching me. It's just a little creepy.
You're the one that writes on the walls.
We all do. For some poor souls down here, it's the only way they can be heard. But you don't want to touch the ink for too long. It can claim you, pull you back. That's how I met Tom. I was messing with things I shouldn't have been, and he was there.
Why do you call him Tom?
He just seems to respond to it.
Well, I don't think he's very fond of me.
Let me show you something. A while back, I was mapping out one of the upper levels when I noticed something reflecting off a piece of glass. I held up the glass, looked through, and on the wall behind me was a hidden message. Right there, in plain sight. So I kept looking and found more and more messages everywhere in the studio. But you can't see them with your eyes. Only through this. Take a look. I don't know who's leaving them, but I think they know how to get out of here.
Where does it all lead to?
Nowhere. I followed them for a long time. Just leads me in circles. I don't think I meant to leave this place, Henry. But maybe you are.
Alice. Please let me out of here.
Tom thinks you're dangerous.
And what do you think?
I think you're the hope I've been waiting for. Go to sleep. Maybe tomorrow will be better. That was really stupid, Tom. You shouldn't have gone out there. Now that he's seen you, it's only a matter of time before he finds us here. We can't just leave him. Not with the ink demon right outside the door.
What's going on?
He's coming. We have to move on. Tom, we have to let him out. I'm sorry.
Sounds like something stuck in the paddle wheel.
Oh! to me. You said I'd be free. Well, I'm going to free you now. Free your head right off your shoulders. Sheep, sheep, sheep. It's time for sleep.
Close. You're lucky we were in the neighborhood.
Was that him?
I don't think so. The Searchers and the Lost Ones built this place. Sammy must have been keeping them at bay, now that he's gone. Looks like we're in for a fight. Get ready. Watch out! Here they come! I think that's all of them. But you never know where they're gonna crawl out of next. Probably best if we stay together from now on. Henry? Think you can lead the way?
Now that's interesting. Always on time. Not these guys again. I better stay out of sight.
Just me.
So it turns out it's my lucky day. I got to cleaning some of the offices around 2 a.m. last night, and what do you think I find on one of the chairs? A big freaking chocolate cake, just sitting there, practically yelling my name. You know, I work hard. I earn my pay, every darn dollar. But you know what this company's missing? Little benefit and points. And this here cake, it's a poik. Hopefully no one finds out what I've done, because if they did, I can tell you what would happen. I'm out of here.
Better get overtime for this. Back to the old grind.
Looks like whatever was here was taken long ago.
How did you get down here?
It pays to carry a rope. You should try it.
Look, I know where we have to go, but it's not gonna be pleasant. The Ink Demon has something that we need. I'm going after him.
You wanna go to his lair? Are you crazy? That's death.
That's where the trail seems to lead.
Well, it's probably close by. Probably through that door. But it won't be easy to open. I'll need 3 gears, a crowbar, some kind of counterbalance. Huh. Well, that works too. I guess.
My old desk. I wasted so much time in this chair.
Quiet. Don't make any noise. See any way around. Nothing to build a raft with.
We'll have to wade across.
We can't. We're not like you, Henry. If we go in there, well, a drop of water in the ocean is rarely seen again.
And I guess it's all up to me. And I don't even know what I'm doing here. I don't even know why this is all happening to me.
You're here for a reason, Henry. There's always a reason. Even when you can't understand it. It's time. Set us free.
They could have at least given me a weapon.
Monsters.
there for his beginning. But he's never seen the end.
The end.
Thank you.
Henry! So soon. I didn't expect you for another hour yet. Now you're just trying to impress me. But I know. You have questions. You always do. The only important question is this. Who are we, Henry? I thought I knew who I was. But the success starved me. Nothing left but lines on a page. In the end, we followed two different roads of our own making. You, a lovely family. Me, a crooked empire. And my road burned. I let our creations become my life. The truth is, you were always so good at pushing, old friend. Pushing me to do the right thing. You should have pushed a little harder. Henry, come visit the old workshop. There's something I need to show you.
All right, Joey. I'm here. Let's see if we can find what you wanted me to see.
Tell me another one, Uncle Joey.